हेलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ मनोज पाटिल, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर सिविल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट फ्रॉम MEPS KBTECOE नासिक। स्टूडेंट, टुडे इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर डिस्कस अबाउट डिसलाइनेशन। सी, इन दिस वीडियो वी आर डिस्कस अबाउट इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ द डिसलाइनेशन, इन दैट व्हाट इज मीन बाय डिसलाइनेशन, देन द वेरियस मेथड्स ऑफ डिसलाइनेशन like the solvent extraction method, electrodialysis method, solar steel, freezing method, that we are discuss here. Then water treatment of the swimming pool, that we are discuss. So see, first one is the desalination. See, what is meant by desalination and why it is necessary? See student, desalination means the process of removal of salt and impurity from the water, that process is called as the desalination. Okay, see, if the water is salty and if you have to utilize it, it will give the bad taste. Okay, so for that purpose we have to do the desalination. The Arab countries like Dubai, okay, in that 99% of drinking water is come from the desalination process, isn't it? So see, desalination process help us to remove the salts and to remove the impurity from the sea water and to make that water drinkable and make that water safe for the drinking purpose. See, there are various methods of desalinations are there, but the application of these various processes or method depends upon the salinity of the water to be treated and the end use of the treated water and the economic budget for the process of the desalination of that water. So these are the various factors which are affecting the to choose the which type of method we have to be used. Okay, so the water which we have to be treated, how much is the salinity of that water, that is the first factor. Then the end use of the treated water, for what purpose we are using that treated water, whether it is for industrial purpose, drinking purpose or any other commercial purpose, that will also means affect the choose the type of which type of process of desalination we have to be used for the desalination purpose. So these are the various factors are there. Now see, we have to, there are various methods like solvent extraction method, electrodialysis method, solar steel, freezing method. Then the reverse osmosis method is also there, which we are already discussed. Okay, that's why I have not covered in this lecture that method, reverse osmosis. So these are the four methods are there which we have to be utilized, four to five methods are there which we have to be utilized for the desalination purpose. Now we have to discuss one by one method in detail. See, first one is the solvent extraction method. See, what is meant by solvent extraction? See, solvent extraction, it is the partial removal of substance from a solution or mixture by dissolving it in another immiscible solvent in which it is more soluble. Okay, see, when the water of having low salinity, that is when the water is having salinity less than 3000 to 10,000 milligram per liter, okay, at that time this solvent extraction method is used. Okay, see, the organic solvent like secondary and tertiary amines are mixed with the oceanic water or sea water to get the more concentrated raffinate, and then an extract containing low salinity water gets separated by heating it. See, this solvent can be recycled, which help to reduce the cost of desalination purpose and make it economical. Okay, see, mostly there are diethyl ether is mostly used as a solvent extraction. See, what is the principle of this solvent extraction is there. See, when the solute, whether it is liquid or solid, is added to a heterogeneous system of two immiscible liquid in both of which the solute is soluble, the solute distributes between the two liquid. This is the principle of that solvent extraction method. Okay, next method is the electrodialysis method. This is the most common method which we have to be utilized for the desalination purpose. See, This process refers to the transport of the ions from the salt solution through the ion exchange membrane as a result of an applied electric field. Okay. See, this electrodialysis method consists of number of cation and anion exchange membranes. Okay. See, as shown here, cation transfer membrane here and cation transfer membrane here, anion transfer membrane here. Okay. So this method consists of number of cation and anion exchange membrane which are arranged alternatively. Okay, and the saline water feeds through the manifold in alternate compartment. So these are the cathode plate, here is the anode plate, and here is alternatively cation membrane is there, here anion membrane is there. Okay, and then water is passed through this membrane. Okay, the saline water is fed through the manifold in the alternate compartment. See, the cation and the anion move toward the cathode and anode. Okay, through the cations and anion move toward the cathode and anode. Okay, the membranes through the cation and anion exchange membrane respectively, and they leaving the back the feed. Okay, which is to be depleted in salts. Okay, while the neighboring compartment became the concentrated. See, here in this figure, here is the cathode plate is shown here, here is the anode plate is there. Okay, and alternately this cation transfer membrane and anion transfer membranes are provided. Again here cation, okay, again here. So water is passed through this membrane, and in this way that desalination process is carried out by this electrodialysis method. Okay, see, this electrodialysis method is very very important and mostly is used for the desalination of the water. Okay, because this method is giving very high result, or this method is having very high efficiency of removing the salts from the water. See, the cation and anions migrate toward the cathode and anode through the cation and anion membrane, isn't it? And the power, see, in electrodialysis process, the power requirement increases linearly with the feed salinity. Okay, so that power, as the salinity of water is increased, the power consumption is also increased. Now next method is the solar still method. Okay, see, the solar still is a very simple way of distilling water. Okay, and using the heat of the sun to drive evaporation from the humid soil and ambient air to cool the condenser flame. Okay, so to desalination purpose, here the solar stills are used. Very simple it is. See, there are two basic types of solar stills are there. One is the box type and the pit still. And in a solar still, impure water is contained outside the collector where it is evaporated by the sunlight shining through the clear plastic. Okay, see here in this diagram that will be shown here. Okay, see, the pure water vapor condenses on the cool inside plastic surface and drips down from the wetted low point where it is collected and it is removed. Okay, see, this is the box type, more sophisticated. Okay, the box type is a more popular method. Okay, see, the salt water, in this what happen, the salt water trickle down the trays mounted on the inclined compartment provided with two glass sides on heated into insulated bag. Okay, in which screens the condenses the chamber from the sun. Okay, and the focusing mirror from an important element. Okay, in the cost of the steel in this case. Okay, and the development of cheaper non-focusing types of mirror and use of inexpensive material of cost of construction have been restored to. See, in basin solar steel, a commonly used design salt water tank filter either by gravity or by the stainless steel impeller pump. Okay, and feed the solar steel whose cover is at shallow angle of 10 degree to 18 degree with the glass pan. Okay, which are tightly sealed to the holding frame, and the joint between the steel cover the vertical walls perfectly tight. So see, See, the basic principle of the solar water distillation are the simple. Yet it is effective and distillation replicate the way nature makes rain. See, the rain sun energy heats water to the point of evaporation. And as the water is evaporated, the water vapor rises and condensing on the glass surface for the collection. Okay. See, this solar steel process removes the impurities such as the salt which are to be present in the water, heavy metal, and it also eliminates the microbiological organisms also. Because due to the temperature, due to the increase in temperature, the bacteria, pathogenic bacteria present in the water, they are get killed. And the end result of that water cleaner than the purest rainwater. Okay. Then the last method, very important method, is the freezing method. See, this freezing method is based on the principle that on lowering the temperature of seawater, okay, it freezes the ice crystal and forms are theoretically free from the saline constituents of the water. See, in freezing method, the crystals can be separated and melted to yield to get good water. See, out of the various processes suggested for the processing of the seawater, like electrodialysis, solvent extraction method, okay, solar steel method, okay, this technique, the principal process envisages use of N-butane as a refrigerant, and the process is prohibitive in cost because mechanical energy and on account of the considerable quantity of pure water required to wash the salt from the ice crust is more. Okay, that's why this is costly method of desalination of saline water, because this method, freezing method, needs use of considerable quantity of pure water to wash the salts from the ice crystal. That's why this method is costly. And the last point is the water treatment of the swimming pool. This is also very important point. It may also sometime ask in your exam. The write a short note on the water treatment of the swimming pool. See, the water in the swimming pool, that should be clean and clear from any harmful bacteria or viruses or algae or any type of impurity, because that water is directly come in contact with our eyes, skin, okay, and whenever we are swimming into the pool, at that time some water is may get enter in our body also. That's why whatever the swimming pool water is there, that should be clear, okay, and that should be free from any pathogenic bacteria, so that we will not suffer from the skin diseases. Okay, so see, there are how the swimming pool treatment is given. So first of all, there are various steps are there. In first step, what we are doing, how we have to clean the swimming pool. First of all, the water is allowed to fall through the screen to remove the solid particle, hair, plasters, leaves from the raw water. So see, first of all, water is passed through the screen to remove the floating matter from the water. Okay, very fine screens are used there, which we have to utilize. Okay, so first of all, from that fine screen, water is passed to remove this floating matter. Next step is a flocculant is added to the water to reduce the turbidity of the water, and mainly colloidal particles like skin tissue, textile fiber, etc., which get bind together and become easy to remove. So next process is the flocculant is added in that water, okay, for the removal of the turbidity of that water. Third step, the floating particles are removed by using the sand filter, okay, and to remove the suspended material, the sand filters are made up of the different layer having different size of sand particle. So these sand filters are made up of the different media like garnet sand or anthracite, or using the fine sand or natural sand. Okay, so third process is the filtration. By filtering that water, the sand particles or suspended floating particles are removed. Next step is the microorganisms are used to remove the organic suspended material, because microorganisms are consume that organic matter which are to be present in the that water as a food, and by that way they are converting that organic suspended material into harmless. And finally, disinfection is to be carried out. Some chemicals like chlorine or ozone treatment is mainly given in the water treatment plant for the disinfection purpose, and in this way that swimming pool is to be clear. So this is the water treatment of the swimming pool. Thank you so much, student. I hope that all of you understand all these desalination methods very well. What is mean by desalination? What are the different methods of desalination, like the solvent extraction, electrodialysis, then the solar steel, and lastly solvent extraction, okay, that freezing method, that all of you get understand very well. If in any method or if you have any problems, you can ask me frankly. Thank you, student.